She could come around but can't stick around. That's how I tease her. Been having my way since a little. I ain't never been no pleaser. Always gonna crush these souls when they realize I don't need them. I don't give a fuck how close we is. You cross the line, I'm squeezing. Every day the same routine. Same, ain't no new team. Never ever had hoop dreams, but I'm balling like I want a ring. Demon time over everything. You don't know how much it really means. Struggle took a toll on them. Oh, had to come and intervene. But I'm key to that Bentley. I'm trying to drive it around. Probably think I'm driving it gently. Nah, I'm speeding through the town. I can't even put my phone down. Trying to show the world how it sound. Around and made the wrong turn. We don't even want to turn around. Lately, I've been thinking, what would I be if I ain't take a risk? Struggle, I hated it at the time. But it's the reason I'm rich. Never see me knocking nobody. I know how hard it can get. Respect whoever on they. Cause you be in your zone when you in it. On your own when you in it. Wake up, look out the window. See the rose in the Bentley when you in it. Cause it reeks. Oh boy, it's so much to see. Gotta learn to keep your balance. Going to sleep on silk sheets. But it used to be a palette. Fell in love with shopping. I'm getting a grip of it. I don't need no stylist. Walking on Mars, spinning back on anything. If it got-
Well, the skies are clear. The sun is out. But don't be deceived. There's a big time nip in the air on this crisp autumn day at Lincoln Financial Field. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup. We are all set to go as it'll be the Carolina Panthers taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in Week 9? This will be returned from deep in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. At their own 18-yard line. First play, and Hurts looking to throw it. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And it looks like one of the DBs has it. And they will take over at the 26-yard line.
To put it mildly, that is not the way anyone wants to start off a game. You fumble on your first offensive snap. But now what you're worried about... throughout the game for your guys on offense, and how's the defense going to handle it? Because no one...
And now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right. The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. Here's Hurts to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Philadelphia.
This is an offense that's near the bottom of the league in rushing, so defensively coming in, you've got to know you're going to see the ball in the air a lot. And that time, it's a completion and a first down on this opening drive.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Go, go, go.
good move. And that one goes for about six as he's taken down just shy of the 45. The Eagles hit 3-5, two games under 500. Charles, they were losers last time out. What do you think they need to do differently here?
Well, I don't think it needs to be as drastic as burning up last week's game tape or not watching it, but the attitude has to be what's done is done. Let's move on. Put that one behind them, galvanize themselves, and go forward and get a win in this one.
From the 44 now, here's 2nd and 4. Going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up. You look at this Carolina defense. They were very good in the win over Dallas a week ago.
And what I saw on film was nearly an unstoppable pass rush. They had 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries. So now do you just max protect on offense, keep everyone in and run, you know, 1 or 2 receiver routes to make sure your quarterback stays up? We'll soon find out.
Hurts sets up to throw it. And they set up the screen. That's complete. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11.
And as you're game planning as a staff, you go through all the different ways you can neutralize the other guy's pass rushers. Extra linemen, leave a tight end in, bring the running backs back in to block. Or you can do this, a little simple screen pass, and it works to perfection.
So from Panther territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 45-yard line. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Watkins.
But yet another completion here on this opening drive, and he's now perfect 4 of 4 to start. Pretty solid execution here.
How about how everyone's handled their nerves? Because you know what it's like to start a ball game. You're so amped up and ready to go that sometimes the execution isn't there. They've been flawless so far. Well drilled, well prepared, and excited to start this game.
Throwing is Hurts. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
And CD, that's the second time this half they've put it on the carpet. Now, the first one they lost. Good news here, it doesn't cost them.
They do say that things even out in the course of a ball game. So you mentioned they lost the first one. This time, able to retain possession, but they can't get it.
Looking for Watkins, and it's intercepted. And the Panthers are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 7.
Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
Here we go. Following the interception, Young. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down.
Good sure hands there from a guy not accustomed to catching a whole lot of passes. But how about the way he's able to pull that one in and pick up good yardage?
Okay. 2 yards to go, 2nd down.
Right.
before reaching the 25. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Panther first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. A play fake, now Young. Finds a man with a crossing route. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll try and run this one right up the gun. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39. You look at this Eagle defense. They currently sit at number four in the NFL in terms of stopping the run.
Numbers don't tell you everything, but they do paint a pretty good picture. We're talking about two top five units going at each other. One in running the ball, one in stopping the run. I think this is going to be a whole lot of fun myself.
Ball on the 39. Here's the second and eight. Young will set to throw. Man open downfield is Diggs. He's got it. Down the left sideline. Touchdown, Carolina. Stephon Diggs. His second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Elliott Good on the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
That one goes for 24 yards. But no matter your experience level as a quarterback, you throw an interception on that first drive, maybe a little shaken up. Nice response there to get their first down.
I think you make an excellent point. I don't care who you are. You throw an interception, it's going to get to you a little bit. But the ones that we've seen that are the best, you never notice it. They don't come to the bench, throw their helmets. They don't do any of that. They just go back out the next drive and act like it never happened. And that's what we're seeing here.
Well, he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Another first down as he went right back to the same well, this time for 17 yards. That's probably as simple of a throw as he'll have all game.
And good for everyone. Good for his completion percentage. Good for the receptions for the receivers. But you know how they work on that. They have footballs with no laces. So that as soon as you get the snap, you're just throwing the football. All right? You're not trying to find the laces and grip it a certain way. That takes time. Just get the ball and throw it. So that's how they practice it all the time now, too.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. Pushing his way through. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Consecutive first down like they had on the first three plays.
You sound almost disappointed there. You want to fire the offensive coordinator on that one or what?
They had gotten into a rhythm. I thought they were just going to keep going.
Well, almost a win for the defense, but if that's your win, you're not doing very well right now.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. Quick hitter here is complete. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up with a first and goal.
Try and run for it on first and goal. And he will take this one in for an Eagle touchdown. A great play there. His third rushing touchdown of the year. And the Eagles are within an extra point of tying up this ball game.
And as a defensive coordinator, you're almost in a no-win situation down here near the goal line. You know how dangerous Jalen Hurts is when he holds on to it. You've got to be prepared to stay with him. So when he hands it off, if you're slow in reacting, this is going to be the result.
Extra point splits the uprights, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this is going to be returned from... And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And they will take over with a football just outside of the 10 at the 12-yard line.
Starting to get the sense throughout the league that more of the special teams coordinators give their guys the green light to bring the ball out because everyone wants big plays to happen. I don't know if that philosophy will hold after that error there, turning it over that deep in their own territory.
Do guys go rogue there a lot based on feeling?
I think a lot of them just sense that they can make a play and make a huge one to help their team. And they have to have that athletic arrogance about themselves. And every now and then, though, it'll cost them. And that's what we just saw there.
A second and 7 with our score tied at 7, but they're planning to change that soon. Only question, will they get 3 or 6 out of it? And here's a handoff out of the gun. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
A great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a 3rd and 4. Hey. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Here is third down and four. One of the tight ends comes in motion. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Working free to drop it for the sack there was Amari Barno. On fourth down, Sean McDermott trots the field goal unit out there. And his kick is indeed good. So the big return had him fired up, but in the end, the offense stalls out. They only muster three.
Yeah, the excitement was there after the return, but they didn't move the ball at all after that. They didn't even get a first down.
This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. 3-5 is where they sit on the year. A very uneven start is certainly not an ideal position to be in at the halfway point of the season. Out of CD, do you see an avenue where they can still be a playoff team, or is that ship sailed?
Well, since you took me to the nautical side, I'm going to try and keep up here because, to me, this ship is about ready to pull out of port. These next couple of games are absolute must-wins for them. Now, if they can win a couple, get to 5-5, maybe they start believing in themselves, but a loss here, that would move them to 3-6. And if that's the case, well, that boat is going to head out to the harbor with them still on the dock. Let's go.
They'll swing this out to Tony. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
Looking at a 2nd and 11 now after the loss. Here's Young from the shotgun. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
He did a fine job there not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. To the air once more, Young. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sand.
On fourth down, Ryan Stonehouse on the punt.
2 minutes remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. Here's Ryan Stonehouse now, standing right on his own 5-yard line. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. And taken right at the 35. 45 yards, that's what the punt goes for, 5 on the return. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
It's a pick up of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4. At the 46-yard line.
Here now, 2nd and 4. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, you know they had a third down play on standby just in case, but he says no need with that carry. Runs like that will continually earn him more work in this and future contests.
Off the play fake, here's Hurts. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. And the Panthers are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield. You don't see this often, a quarterback of his caliber, 2 first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? Here's Young. This might be a free play. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44.
So they'll accept that penalty, and that'll, of course, move the football up the field.
So this helps to start a drive. After the penalty, it'll be 1st and 5. Hands it off out of the gun. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Young now from the 50. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sack back at the 46. That's big Jordan Davis powering in to drop it. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Third and 12.
Defensive coaches constantly preach not allowing any run after the catch. They give up a few more yards than they wanted to, but they were able to get him down quickly and force a fourth down.
And it's his goal. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance.
Charles, even as long field goals become more and more common, this is still a very rarefied air. Only just over 20 field goals have been kicked from 60 yards or further, and you can add his name to the list now.
And as calm as he tried to present himself, there's no doubt there were some nerves as he lined up to attempt that kick. But once the ball was snapped, he just swept the leg and boom, over the crossbar.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And with only 4 seconds on the clock, time likely for just one snap of the football. They'll throw now on the final play. And Hurts is intercepted, his third of the game. It's C.J. Henderson picking it off, and he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. It's a tight football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. Yikes, a 4-yard loss really sets him back now for second down.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. They'll have to deal with a second and 14 now after the loss. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. So that time, they got the left guard with a hold.
And let's face it, in today's ball, you might have that 330-pound guy you're supposed to clear out of there. You might need a little bit of extra help by grabbing the jersey and trying to ride him out.
Now after the holding call, here's second and 20. shot here on the ground. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. Give him 4 yards there, but still in a big hole. Third and long.
Well, I'm hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
How to approach this. Third down and 16 yards to go. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And the Eagles with a dime look. Six DBs on third down. This one go deep for Chark. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Some coverage there, and they were getting deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there's not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. So possession goes over here on the punt. And it will be Eagles football, first and 10. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
Second down, 8 to go from the 28. He'll look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 14 yards there, and an Eagle first down.
They certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized.
Ball on the 47-yard line. Here's second and 6. And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Here is third and 5. to throw here. Going deep here for Watkins. And this is caught. Touchdown, Eagles. Cole Watkins, 53 yards. And the Eagles had taken the lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Extra point right down the middle, and that makes it a 17-10 score. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Now this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They find themselves down 17-10 as they come up on a first and 10. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
Hitting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end.
Ball spotted at the 45. Here's second and a couple. Side complete to Tony.
Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
And it's pretty evident that this passing game has been frustrated so far. They haven't really moved the ball the way we might have expected, but this is a good pickup here for the first down.
Down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he's able to motor his way down to the 16-yard line. That's another gain of 15 on back-to-back plays.
And the Panther first down.
Here we go, back.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10.
Right, 97. Ready.
And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. A 16-yard touchdown run.
And the Panthers are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And an important one that is, as we are all tied now early in this fourth quarter.
Now this one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the fourth as the kick's away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. At the line, this Philly offense set to go. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. Pretty solid run here on first down. Almost picked up another first, but he appears to be a few inches short.
Now that was an excellent run, and when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job. And then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. Keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 51 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Well, how many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice gain.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 in the first.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 34. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Snap will come from the 31 on second and 7. This one out quickly to Watkins.
He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of six.
That's a gain of six. Brings up third and one.
Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides. Oh, the sneak, it's Hurts. He is going nowhere as he is enveloped behind the line. So call that no gain on the sneak, and now they're still a yard short here on fourth.
No gain? Quarterback sneak? No gain? Aren't you supposed to get something out of that?
Yeah, needed a full yard there. Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. They go play action with Hurts. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the fourth down attempt and keeping the drive alive? Now first and goal. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
That's good power football on first and goal. A lot of teams will throw from there. But that's a nice job to chew up a few more yards and get yourself closer to the goal line.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. Here now, second and goal. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken. With 1:55 remaining, two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4-down territory.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. Third down and goal coming up here. Now back to throw. And the Eagles answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And they will take a 7-point lead now. Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. At their own 18-yard line. Here's first and 10. Now Young, able to connect with Chark, gets past one man, and way up past the 35 before he's taken down. He's been quiet all afternoon. He may have just come up with a play of the day right there, though.
Obviously, it's not the volume in what you get done, it's the quality, and that was a quality catch right there.
Plenty of time and two timeouts still at their disposal. First and 10 here. Here's Young. Quick hitter here is complete. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Obviously a big first down right there.
Yeah, they still got to hustle. They got to get up to the line of scrimmage and get set. But I don't think necessarily you need to spike it. But they've got to continue to move quickly.
They'll come up first and 10 here. Second of their timeouts as a stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Here's second down. Young to throw. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. And the Eagles have just about sewn up this football game. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
Low on first down, but it's not going to get him much. Maybe a yard, and that's all. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout. as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. Hurts down to one knee, and that should just about do it.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. Here's Hurts to throw. Going up top. And it's incomplete. They're still throwing to the very end. But now this game is over. So it's a victory here for the Philadelphia Eagles. And a little bit of a surprise, they lose the turnover battle, but wind up winning the ballgame.
And this is very unusual because you know all teams stress winning the turnover battle as a key indicator to winning ballgames. So when you get something that goes against the grain like the one we saw here, it's quite the oddity. Now let's face it, they'll be very happy that they pulled this off, but they do know that in the future, they've got work on taking care of the football because this won't happen very often.
So for Philadelphia, it's an important win for their postseason hopes as they at least get back to 4-5. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, their season is on life support somewhat now at 3-6. And they're going to get an extra week to stew over this as they're not back in action until week 11. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.